I'll take you through. So whatever we have learnt in the first 45 minutes, we are going to use it again in the last 30 minutes. Right? If there are no questions, then we will apply all this learning in the last 30 minutes, and that will make you clearly understand how, you know, what's exactly Six Sigma and how come Six Sigma can be, you know, useful in your business, right? And now before up to, let's say, for up to 8:30 or 8:40, I will try to take you through the DMAC phases one by one: define, measure, analyze, improve, and control, right? And the important steps, tools, and deliverables. So suppose if you are in the define phase of an improvement project in your organization, you should be able to answer few critical questions. If you could answer properly for all these questions, the define is done. You can move on to the measure phase. So these are the questions. Is this project important to business? Obviously, it is important to you. But is this project also important to your business? The answer should be yes. Then only your project will be approved by your boss. We call him project sponsor. Does a business case exist? You expect the resources to be provided. Let's say 25 lakhs is required to run your project for the next 6 months. If I put 25 lakhs, what is in it for me? And that is called business case. If you can say, sir, you will get 40 lakhs saving every quarter. That means 1.6 crore saving every year. It's a recurring saving. And what is the investment required? At 25 lakhs. So if you can speak like that, you can say a business case exists in your project and the chance of getting approved will also be higher. Have you identified the CTQs? This is very, very important question. CTQ means critical to quality. These are nothing but the characteristics in your product or features in your product and service which customer, no, which actually impacts your customer satisfaction. So unless and until you identify the CTQs, problem is not understood fully. So CTQ means critical to quality characteristics, nothing but the measurable characteristics, right? For example, let me give you a scenario. Imagine a parent takes their child for vaccination. Parents are taking their child for a vaccination. And now the doctor is, you know, giving the injection, and now the child cries a lot. Now the child is crying a lot. And suppose if you are given a project, if you are given a project to see to that, whenever an injection is given, the child should not cry. Now this is the project. And all of you are able to understand the context of the problem. What is the problem here? The child is crying. And you have to ensure, no, the child doesn't cry much when injection is given. And if this project is given to you, tell me, how will you handle the problem? Or, no, how will you solve the problem? Can you all start sharing your views?
Yeah, maybe place few toys around where the vaccination or whatever injection is being given. Okay. To deviate the child's, yeah.
Okay. So Sangeeta madam has given her point. She will give some toys so that the child can play while the injection is given. Very good.
And also talking with them, we can distract them. That's what doctors do.
So what Giridharan will do, Giridharan will keep on talking to the child when the vaccination is given, right? The child will get distracted and then doctor can do the injection. Very good. Second idea. Third idea.
We can give some chocolates and food, whatever he likes.
Very good. Now, Mitesh Darji is telling he will give some chocolates and sweets to the child so that the child, you know, can enjoy the chocolate while the vaccination is given. And now, any other idea coming on? Somebody would like to sing a song?
Maybe instead of injection, maybe oral drops or something so that it doesn't pain kid.
Yeah, that is out of scope right now because, you know, that's called product development, okay. New product development. And you have to improving the current product, and your point is definitely valid. That's a good suggestion, but that comes under a new product development. Instead of injection, you are going for a oral, right? So let's talk only about injection, right? And maybe some of you would like to sing a song for the child. And some of you might even like to dance in front of the child so that the child can enjoy the vaccination. Am I right? So these are all the ways by which we try to solve a problem. Tell me honestly, are you really trying to solve the problem or you are trying to invite additional problems? Come on. When you dance in front of the child, do you think the child will stop crying or will start crying more?
It will also, if it likes the songs that they dance, it will start. It will also start dancing.
Yeah, it depends. It depends on the performance.
So we are not trying to solve the problem. We are trying to amplify the problem by way of doing all these things, dancing in front of the child and singing in front of the child and offering some sweets and giving some toys. We are actually trying to amplify the problem. This is how all of us go wrong while defining the problem. And now let me ask the question very precisely. Tell me, what is that really making the child to cry? The pain at the time of injection, am I right?
Yes.
Why the pain comes? Why the pain comes? Because an injection is, the needle is going inside the muscle, am I right?
Now
I am telling you, the size of the needle causes the pain and the child cries. Am I right? So the source of the problem is needle size. Can I say like that? The size of the needle is the source of the problem. More the size of the needle, more will be the pain, and then the child will cry. All of you are with me on this, am I right?
If you use a thinner needle, it will also create pains, no sir?
Yes, but my only point is that the pain is coming down?
Maybe.
Not maybe, it will come down. If you have to take an injection, right? No, and the doctor says, I will give you an injection with the needle of, let's say, 5 mm. Will you take the injection? 5 mm is very big, right? And you may ask for 0.5 mm. Sir, what is this? 5 mm, this is not for human beings, right? So that's why, the injections are made very, very thin. So, of course, the thin needle...
But kids are not that intelligent that 0.5 mm will not hurt them.
See, 0.5 will also cause the pain. But if you can reduce the size of the needle from the current level, it will definitely bring down the pain. That is the point. Am I right or not? Ultimately,
we know, but the kids doesn't know that.
No. See, you are the problem solver, not the kid. Kid is your customer, right? We need not expect the customer to solve the problem themselves. We have the responsibility to keep our customers happy, to keep our customers satisfied. So the size of the needle is a CTQ here. If you can work on redesign of the needle and by reducing its size, what will happen? The pain can go down. So the size of the needle is one of the CTQ, right? And if the size of the needle is a CTQ, now another challenge comes. What is the challenge? Now medicine has to flow inside the needle, isn't it? The medicine has to flow inside the needle. Now, will you be able to drill a hole inside that 0.5 mm? This is called critical to business. It's a business problem. Earlier is customer's problem. Now, by properly understanding the customer's problem, now you understand there is a business problem, which is drilling a hole inside the 0.5 mm. If both are possible, a solution evolves, a product evolves, quality happens. If one out of the two is not possible, what will happen? You end up producing a product which your customers know is not satisfied much. That means it will have a quality issue. Otherwise, the product may not bond. So always you have to identify measurable characteristics that will truly reflect the pain. Always you should be able to figure out measurable characteristics which will truly reflect the pain experienced by your customer. And those are called CTQs. It could be dimension, it could be hardness, or it could be any metric which can talk about your customer's problem, right? For example, suppose this training program, white belt training program. And suppose if you feel that, the time allotted is not sufficient. Now, what is the CTQ you are talking about? The training time. yesterday 90 minutes and today 90 minutes, this 180 minutes is not sufficient. So CTQ is the training time. So now what should I do? I must consider increasing this CTQ. When I increase the CTQ, what will happen? Your satisfaction can go up. At the same time, when I go beyond certain level, your satisfaction can get affected badly. So I have to stay at the optimum level. So this is how you should also work while trying to solve any problem. Our project plans and key milestone identified. You said your project is for 6 months. What is that you will achieve at the end of 6 months? What is that you will achieve at the end of every month? What is that you will achieve at the end of every week? You must have a plan. And for that, you should have the project plan and key milestones. All these questions, you should have the answer. Then only your project will have a better chance of getting approved by your top management. And there are several tools you can consider using to get all these questions answered effectively. The first one is project charter. Nothing but a brief, or I would say an executive summary about your project. A one-page document which will talk clearly about the problem, which will talk clearly about the business case, which will talk clearly about the scope, goal, and the team member and the key milestone. A simple one-page document, if you can create, make it impressive, and any top management by quickly going through your project charter can go ahead and then approve your project. All that you need to do is, you must present your project in a quickly understandable way. You can add few graphs and then project the problem very clearly. At the same time, project the business case very clearly with some visuals and make it in a one page or maximum two page document. We call it a project charter. And then Kano model is a tool which will help you to understand your customer's requirement better than the customer himself know about it. Right? So because customer always have requirement, we call it spoken and unspoken requirement. They'll speak about certain thing and then forget to speak about many things. So there are two set of requirement. One is spoken, another one is unspoken. Then how will you understand both? Right? And there is a tool called Kano model, and not only understand, you will also be able to prioritize. Right? And then SIPAC. SIPAC is a tool standing for supplier, input, process, output, and customer. Process means there are several steps. Every step, there will be an input, there will be output. And who gives the input? He is called supplier. Who receives the output from the process? He is called customer. Customer is not always the end user. End user is the ultimate. Final product goes to him. But before producing the final product, there are a lot of intermediate stages. Those intermediate output will be received by the intermediate customers. We will call them internal customer. So understand the internal customers always and try to satisfy the internal customer. If you satisfy the internal customer, your end user can also get satisfied, right? So for that, what is that your end user, what is that your internal customer wants? That should be your process output. And accordingly, you should have process steps. And for that purpose, you must provide the appropriate input. And who will supply that input? He is called supplier. So this tool is called SIPAC, nothing but an acronym, standing for supplier, input, process, output, and customer. And Pareto. Pareto is one of the QC tool which you can use to prioritize your problem in the define phase, prioritize your causes in the analyze phase, prioritize your solution in the improve phase. You can use it whatever way you want. It is simply a prioritization tool, right? CTQ tree. Just now I spoke about it, right? CTQ. And the customer statements are always vague. It will not be, immediately measurable. When the child cries, how can you measure? But when you understand it is the needle size which is causing the pain, you can start measuring it. Oh, needle size is 0.5. So if I make it 0.4, the pain can reduce. If I make it 0.3, the pain can still reduce, isn't it? So that's how you will be able to impact the customer satisfaction. Unless and until you identify the right CTQ, you will never be able to solve the problem. And that is what happened in our discussion also. We tried many, many ways, but we are not really able to impact this customer satisfaction, isn't it? And Y is equal to F of X is simply, the tool which I talked about yesterday. Y is the dependent variable, X are the independent variable. And toll gate review is nothing but at the end of every phase, a set of critical questions will be asked to the Six Sigma team. And as a team, you should be able to answer and convince your, management on all those important questions. We call it tollgate review. And now another video, which will, this is, I've showed this video only to let you understand identification of right CTQ is very important. If you don't identify the CTQ, or if you wrongly identify the CTQ, a similar thing can happen with respect to our products and our services also, right? Whatever your customer wants, and express it in terms of CTQs. A single product can have 100 CTQs, and your product, you know, should be able to deliver all the CTQs, right? And so there is a tool called Kano model, which generally product development team makes use of, and to prioritize the customer requirement, right? It is to be used after gathering VOC. VOC means voice of customer. What is that your customer expects? With some surveys and questionnaire, you can capture all your customer requirement and convert the voice of customer into CTQ. Once the voice of customer is converted into CTQ, prioritize using this Kano model, right? And it is this professor called Noriaki Kano developed this Kano model in 1980s. And according to Professor Noriaki Kano, there are three types of requirements, customer requirement. First one is called must be requirement. That means no compromise. This has to be there in the product, right? And second is called performance requirement, second level. Third level is called attractive. The must be's are called the dissatisfier. Performance are called the satisfier. Attractive features are called the delighters, right? And this is represented visually here. X-axis talks about the functionality. Y-axis talks about the satisfaction. If the product performs well, you are on the right side of the x-axis. If the product performs bad, you are on the left side. If as the product performs well, and if your satisfaction goes high, now you are moving in the y-axis, right? If as the product doesn't perform well, and the customer satisfaction, if it goes down, now you are on the bottom of the y-axis, right? Now you understood x-axis, y-axis. Now this dark blue color represents the must be features. The green color represents the performance feature, and the light blue color represents the delight feature. What are they talking about? We need to discuss one by one. And let me give one example here. Imagine all of you are going to a restaurant with your family. All your family members are going to a restaurant, and that restaurant is providing you a very good hand wash facility. They're good in the sense it's neat, clean, and you know, water is also clean, and everything is fantastic. It's like a 5-star hotel, right? And now this hand wash facility provided to your family in the restaurant, is it a satisfier or a dissatisfier? What is your opinion? All of you can try to answer this question. A hand wash facility is a feature in the restaurant. Am I right? Is it a feature?
Yes.
Yes. If you also start a restaurant, you will have definitely this feature in your restaurant. And now this particular feature, your restaurant is performing beautifully. Functionality is great. And now tell me this particular feature, is it a satisfier or a dissatisfier?
Satisfier.
Yes. Yes, we think it is satisfier. Suppose if you get satisfied, how generally a customer will behave? For example, you go to a movie and movie was really great. You liked it. What will you do? You will refer to your friends.
Yes.
Refer to your colleagues. You will write a review. Maybe you yourself will watch it again and again and again. And now, suppose if you think this as a satisfier, tell me, will you do all these kind of activities which you did it for the movie? Will you write a review about the restaurant? Will you refer the restaurant based because the hand wash facility is beautiful? Will you go to the restaurant again and again because the hand wash facility is beautiful? Answer is no.
No.
But no. On the other hand, if you don't, because your main purpose is food, isn't it? You came for the food. But at the same time, if I don't provide you a hand wash facility, if I ask you to go to the dining table directly, how many of you will like my restaurant? None of you?
Yeah.
All of you will walk out. That means this particular feature is not a dissatisfier, but definitely a dissatisfier. If I don't do well, all of you will go back. But if I do really well, you may consider my restaurant. You don't write the review and other things. You may step inside and then you will start checking my food, isn't it? This yes. Definitely, this feature is a dissatisfier. Dissatisfiers are called must be features.
Must be, yes.
Yeah. That means if there are 100 must be features, you must definitely include it in your product. It doesn't mean customer will buy your product. But if you don't do well, definitely customer will reject your product. That's why they are called dissatisfier. All of you are with me on this?
Understood? Yes.
Yes.
So that means, you know, we have to really understand how each feature in our product impacts the customer satisfaction. Is it impacting positively, or is it impacting negatively, or is it impacting proportionally? Accordingly, no, we have to prioritize. The moment you understand a particular feature is a must-be feature, no compromise. If you compromise, you are losing your customer, and you will lose the chance to launch your product in the market. How many of you will start a restaurant without a hand wash facility? You have invested 100 crores, but hand wash facility is not there. Your business is a flop. Your product is really a flop, isn't it? So don't do that. If there are hundreds of must-be features, even thousands of must-be features, if you want to be in the business, you have to provide all the must-be features in your product. And so, if you are in a project mode, if you have completed the defined phase, the main deliverable you have to produce is your project should be approved. That means your project charter should be approved. So approved project charter is one deliverable. And another deliverable is SIPOC. What is SIPOC? Supplier, Input, Process, Output, Customer. SIPOC will give you a high level view of the process which you are trying to improve. Because when you want to improve your result, identifying the right process is important. So you have to give a clue to the project sponsor that you have the capability to identify the process which is actually causing the failure. And that's why SIPOC is also needed. And SIPOC will definitely have a high level process map, which is nothing but a 30,000 foot view of your process. You would not necessarily have to show all the steps in your process, at least to show 5 steps in your process. And this is how your typical project charter might look like, nothing but a simple template, which will be approved by, which will be signed by the project charter, which will be signed by the finance controller and approved by the project sponsor. We call this project charter a 6-pack project charter because it talks about the 6 important points: business case, problem statement, goal statement, scope statement, and then, you know, timelines and team. And you can always add few more important points. You can add visuals to make it very impressive, and thereby, you know, your project can quickly get approved. So this is how, you know, a team will be working in the defined phase. So what are the